Today's video is going to be one part rant, several parts tips and tricks, and all about saving time when culling through your photos. You know, at the end of the day, your life is sort of the sum total of the stuff that you focused on, the stuff that you're spending time doing. I certainly don't want part of that sum total of my life to be culling through, you know, hundreds and thousands of photos. So I have a workflow that works for me. It involves a program called Photo Mechanic, and it's using a combination of Photo Mechanic plus Lightroom together. Photo Mechanic is not a cheap program. It's about $140 to buy it, but you buy it, you don't rent it. I use it for the time-saving feature alone. Let me show you in real time what that is.
We now come to the part of the video where I need to do a demonstration. I'm going to shoot uncompressed raw images on the Fujifilm X-T3 camera so that I can
fill up this card in its entirety. Let's put the card in the camera. I'm just going to take a bunch of random shots. So here, one of the computer. I got it in high-speed burst mode. That buffer is going crazy. Stop! All right, I've shot enough pictures. That's it. I am going to open up the Untitled DCIM folder, as you can see right here. Okay, there's all my pictures. There's 620 files here, an even mixture of RAW and JPEG files. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna import it into my computer. I am just going to drag it onto my desktop. That's all I'm going to do. Just drag it onto my desktop, and there it goes. This is gonna take 8 minutes. I'm gonna then show you how fast I can go through them using Photo Mechanic and then bringing them into Lightroom. While that's doing it, I need to talk to you about Adobe.
The Photoshop Lightroom plan is about 10 bucks a month. It doesn't sound like a lot. 10 bucks a month, a couple cups of coffee, big deal. The problem is that at 10 bucks a month, it's forever. So in a year, you've now dropped $120 on the software. Here's the issue. There's no incentive for them to really add really cool new things because you're gonna pay 10 bucks a month for that software until. Back in the old days, when you bought upgraded versions, there was a real incentive for the company to get you to buy it. They really had to roll out features, and because they were putting out a big release, they really double-checked and triple-checked bugs and problems and listened to users and really had to make sure that they were giving you an A-plus product because the upgrade price was considerable. Lightroom Classic, I got my concerns about. I think that they're just kind of letting that one go. First of all, when a software company calls a software product classic, instead of calling it, you know, desktop version or pro version or something like that, that's when I start running for the hill.
Ah, okay, it's done. I'm gonna open up Photo Mechanic right now. There's the folder, the DCIM. There's my Fuji folder. There's all my pics, see that? I am doing this in real time. I am not pausing the video. In fact, here's what I want you to do. You see the satellite image right there? Keep your eye on that too. And for those of you doubters, I want you to roll back this video and watch. There is no jump cuts. I am not cutting. For the next little bit, there will be no editing, no jump cuts. I want you to see how fast this is in real time. Here we go. I'm gonna take this folder and I'm dragging it 3, 2, 1, drop. Look at that. Do you see how fast that came on? Look at this. Look at this. Boom. That's incredible. I gotta do this again. That's so cool. All right, watch this. I'm gonna do it again. I'm gonna take the folder. Watch now. Here we go. Take the folder, move it over, and drop. Look at that. Look at that. All the way down to the end. All the way down to the end. These are Fujifilm RAW uncompressed files. So now what I do in my process, now I've got them. First thing I do Command A, or I, you know, select all, I right click and I say rename photos. And now I could rename them test shots. Okay. That's all I'm doing. And I'm hitting rename. Boom. Done. They're all renamed. Check it out. Check it out, test shots, you see that? And it's got really intelligent renaming, so you can put in, you know, incrementing numbers, you could do all kinds of things with it. So I've renamed them. Now I'm gonna go through them. This is like the initial call. So what I do is I hit the space bar, up comes the picture, I look at it, that's all right, that one's fine, and I just move forward through each one, you know, with the arrow key, that one's fine, that one's fine, that one's blurry, and I just hit delete, gone.
That one's delete, gone, delete, gone, delete, gone, delete, 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 delete. Do you see how fast it is? You get carpal tunnel syndrome. So once I've done that, then let's say I find a picture that I like. So let me go find something that doesn't, you know, doesn't suck. Ah, that one's terrible. Okay, how about this one? Ah, no, that one, delete. Okay, all right, this one right here. This is my audio preamp. I'm going to mark this picture with 5 stars because I happen to like it. So I hit the 5 key on my keyboard and you see down here, it's got the little star rating, okay? So you can star them. I don't do 2 stars, 3, you know, 10 years from now, what's the difference between a 2-star and a 3-star photo? What I do is I say, if this picture is something that I want to be buried with, it's 5 stars. If it's something that I'm gonna share, possibly sell, do whatever, that it's really good, I'm gonna give it 4 stars. And guess what? Anything else either gets no stars at all, it's just kind of there as a picture, a backup stored, or I delete it. That's it. It's fast, fast, fast. That's what you gotta do. So now I'm done. I close Photo Mechanic. Okay, I'm gonna import it now into, now you see, look how slow that is already. Ding, 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 ding. It's getting there, it's getting there. So here it is, minimal previews, and I'm gonna click import, okay? Okay, so in they come, in they come. Okay, remember when I told you about that 5-star rating thing? Check this out. When I go here and I say, okay, attribute, 5 stars, there it is. So if you star rate it in Photo Mechanic, it will carry through into Lightroom. That is speed, ladies and gentlemen, that's speed. Because I can open up Photo Mechanic, star rate them, delete, 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 delete. Once I've done that and I've culled them down, I can bring them into Lightroom and it's fast. That's it. So I don't know about Lightroom. I'm looking around. I'm looking around, I'm looking at Capture One, and I wanna move away from Lightroom, I just do. I'm not seeing the innovation, I'm not seeing the real exciting stuff. I hear a bunch of vaporware promises. It's slow, it's prone to crashing. This is my laptop, and if you look at my specs, here they are right here. I mean, come on, look at these specs. But I come into Lightroom, and everything just kind of slows down and it's, yeah, I don't know, it's comfortable. I've been using Lightroom for many years and there are things about Lightroom I love, I still love, I do love it. And I'm so used to the sliders and so it's gonna be a transition because I just think one bright and sunny day, Lightroom Classic is just gonna get abandoned. I believe that. And everybody can contradict me till the cows come home. I'm still gonna believe that. I take my software very seriously. Because it's my time. And my time is very valuable to me, as it, I'm sure, is to you as well. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, let me know. If you think it sucks, let me know. And I will see you in the next video. Thanks again. Okay. Well, if you ever wanted to know how fast it can just keep going,